Abantu, they loved it and they understood. But also that is because of the aesthetics that we use in the show. So that it doesn't only rely on spoken word, but also we touch on all the senses. So if you don't get what you hear, you smell it. If you can't smell it, you taste it. If you can't taste it, you definitely feel it. You know what I mean? So it was very important for us as Mandla's directors. In every work that we do, we come from a physical theatre background, so also the body language becomes very important. So the story itself, it becomes universal. It doesn't only belong to the Xhosa people, it doesn't belong to the Eastern Cape, it doesn't belong to Cape Town, it can be staged in Bloemfontein and people love it.
You could see the story actually, even if it's a story of men, the story is controlled by a woman, it's a story of a mother. And me and Thando, most of our stories are led by women, and in the story they possess the power to change the narrative, to shift the thinking, and to critically challenge the notions of socio-political issues about in that story. But also they possess so much power of healing, but also they're so forgiving, and they're so forgiving because they understand that at the end they want that family together. Their responsibility is for the next generation to understand that. Because if it was anyone else, she could have lost the daughter and the son, and the entire family could have been destroyed. But she never gave up to give back the umbilical cord, say, here, take it. And after that, she could not celebrate. She looked around, she found out that her daughter is not here. She went to go and hunt her. She brought her back. And that, for me, it's a family that builds stronger communities. But it's actually a rejection or objecting for any kind of evil to come within the family. And there's something important about the family in an African culture. Because we believe that no village, no community, and no country or nation can be built with broken families.